हेलो टूट्स देन होप यू गॉट वाई देन एम टी सी पी आई पी या केम टूगेदर फॉर दैट नेटवर्क टेक्नोलॉजी नाउ इन दस इन आफ्टर दैट इन दैट चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू सी द टी सी पी ट्रांसमिशन कंट्रोल प्रोटोकॉल सेपरेटली। सो इन दिस टी सी पी फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इफ यू सी द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स इन द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स फर्स्ट वन इज टी सी पी इज ए रिलायबल byte stream port to port transport layer protocol. You see here, it's a reliable byte stream port to port transport layer protocol. Here we have to understand this one, byte stream. Here byte stream in the sense, in the TCP, suppose your packet size is 100 bytes. Here byte stream in the sense, of course without TCP or with TCP, everything will go in the form of either bits or bytes. Means a group of bits is we are calling as a byte. But here we are specifically calling why we are calling as a byte stream is here. In the TCP, we are giving for each byte single sequence number. For each byte, suppose its size is 100 bytes, so we have the sequence numbers from 0 to 99. That should start from any starting number, but altogether we will use the 100 sequence numbers for each byte. For each byte, we are going to give one sequence number. That sequence number lengthy also 32 bits. Here we have to observe one thing. Actual data bit data is 1 byte, means 8 bits. But here for sequence number we are using 32 bits because that's why it became reliable. Okay. So then this is the one of the major characteristic of TCP. Then second one is it uses cumulative technology. Hope you know what actually the meaning of cumulative acknowledgement. TCP is going to give the acknowledgement for group of the packets. That group of the packets either by unit of time or by or every unit of group of packets received. So this is the one of the characteristic. Then if you move to the next one, actually TCP will use full duplex connections. Full duplex connection means transmitting the data, we have the source and destination we have. We can transmit the data at a time both the directions. That is possible in this full duplex connection. But for outside it will look as a full duplex. When you go for the implementation, it is actually the two half duplex connections. It is actually two half duplex connections, like means a source and you have the destination. This is only it is this direction and this is only this direction. So, but at a time is not possible on a single connection in the both the directions. Simultaneously it's not possible. But because of having two connections here, and we are seeing as a overall, means this is possible. So, and these directions are changed. We can change it, and in the connection 1 and this is the connection 2, after some time you can forward the data in this direction. After some time you can forward data in opposite direction, and in this link you can forward data in opposite direction. This is possible, that's why we are calling as a full duplex. But when you go for implementation inside, we are calling it as a two half duplex connections are there actually inside. Now the next characteristic is here TCP is actually in transport layer protocol, in the transport layer. So in the transport layer actually we have a flow control. That is one of the responsibility of the transport layer. So to control this flow, we are using the sliding window protocol for flow control. Now here the thing is, we have the source and we have the destination. It will use four windows actually. How four windows is, to transmit the data, it needs the transmission window, sender's window. This is the sender's window. So whatever sender will send to receive that data, whatever sender will send to receive the data from the destination side, he need receiver window. Okay. At the same time, if he want to transmit the data, he need sender's window. And at the same time, to receive the data, he need receiving window. Sending window, receiving window at the source side, and the sending window and the receiving window at the destination side. That's why we need four windows in this TCP. Then next one, very important one, is TCP connection. TCP connection, actually we have three phases are there. Means to actually establish the TCP connection and to forward the data and to terminate it, we have the total three phases are there. In that, first phase is connection establishment phase. Connection establishment phase. In this actually we have the source and the destination is there. We are transmitting, to transmit the data, it's like a simply a phone connection. To talk with another person, first of all you have to make the connection. Means for that we are dialing that, and then connection is established between the two persons. Then you are talking each other, means simply data you are transmitting each other, sharing each other. After that you are going to terminate. In the same thing here also, in the connection establishment phase, it's going to establish the connection by three handshakes. That first one is, source will request the connection. This is the first one, first handshake. Then after that, if the destination is available, in the sense destination is not that much loaded or he is free, if he is saturated, he is not going to give the, he is going to give the negative reply. If he is not saturated, means still he can handle the more connections, he is going to give reply for that request. We can't call this as a acknowledgement. He is giving reply for this request. Now, after this, if he got the positive reply, means he can establish the connection. So he is going to give the acknowledgement for that reply. Means after this acknowledgement, the source whatever he is sending, that is the actual data. So after this, exactly after this, you have the connection from the source to destination side. Means this connection is established, one half duplex connection is established. Then if destination also want to give the data, transfer the data, he have to go for this process once again. So with this connection is established, now you can transmit the data. Then in the second stage, in the second stage is data transmission. In the data transmission, you can transmit the data simply source to destination. Source will transfer whatever he want to transfer the data to destination. Then the destination also, if he want to give the data to his source, he will transmit. This is the data transmission stage. Then if you come to third one, after talking each other, we are going to cut the connection. So that is actually here is termination, connection termination phase. So here is for this source will request the connection to terminate. It will request the connection to terminate. Then destination will give acknowledgement. So that connection is lost. One connection is lost. After that, if destination side also you want to terminate the connection, he is going to do the same steps, and then he will give the acknowledgement. So this connection is also lost. So these are the in this way we have the three phases to transmit the data. First of all, you have to establish the connection. After that, you have to transmit the data each sides. Then you have to terminate the connection. So these are the majorly characteristics of the TCP. And the first one is the byte stream. For each byte, we are going to give one sequence number. That's why we are calling as a byte stream. And then it will use the cumulative acknowledgement. And then it's a full duplex connection, but internally it's a two half duplex connections. Then it is in the transport layer protocol, so that it have the responsibility is the flow control. For that it is using SWP, and then it have that for the connection to establish the connection to transmit the data. We have the three phases: connection establishment, data transmission, and then connection termination phase. Hope you got the characteristics of the transmission control protocol. Thank you.